afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. On behalf of Dick Gamester, president of Central Little League, Mike McCann, president of National Little League, Ted Stazak, general manager of the Portsmouth Herald, David Sullivan, editor of the Portsmouth Herald, and Rusty Wilson, Portsmouth Recreation Director, I wish to welcome you to the 1993 Portsmouth Herald City Little League Championship game between visiting Pic-N-Pay Grocers and the hometown Ricci Hard Hat. Okay, members of Pic-N-Pay, number 34, Colby Gamester. Number 61, Andrew LeBlanc. And now the starting lineup. Batting first and playing second base, Luke Doucette.
Field.
we're going to have a few words from some of these distinguished guests. After we have the words, still stay on the baseline. We still have to do the national anthem and the first pitch. First of all, Sam, this is your field, Mr. Gamester. Speak.
Thank you, Pat. I'd like to welcome the gentleman from the Portsmouth Herald and Rusty Wilson here, and all of the parents from the National League and the American League and those from the Central League. I don't remember the last time we had two teams from the same league in the city finals, but tonight I just want one team to win, and that's the one with the white pants. Play ball and have fun.
Okay, Mike McCann, president of National League. He's the one that, with Mr. Gamester, put this tournament together this year, as in the past few years, and I think did a very good job.
Thanks, Pat. One group of people I would like to thank tonight, and four of them are represented here tonight, and that is the umpiring crew. For the first time since we've had this tournament, we've had an umpiring pool, non-American, national, or central umps, and we've had four. They mentioned Pat announced the four names of the guys working the game tonight, but I would like to pay tribute to the guys that are not here tonight, and believe me, I had it was a hard choice, and I didn't want to hurt anyone's feelings. Typically, I only allow three umpires to work my game, but because of the quality of umpires this year, we have four tonight. But I would like to announce the other people who graciously gave their time, and this is the first tournament that I have not heard any major complaining about the umpires this year. The other people that supported us with umpiring this year: George Silva, Eddie Ramos, John Clark,
all right,
Wayne Hatch, Joe Udiff, John Cleavener, and I would particularly like to thank Harry Smith out of the American Little League for giving us the name for some more umpires. We had more umpires than we can use this year, and they did a super job, and I'm grateful with playing all games on neutral fields this year and having a neutral umpiring crew. My worst fear, I will send the wrong umpiring crew and a wrong team to the wrong field, but that didn't happen. So I'd like to congratulate the two Central Little League teams. Dick does remember when the last time the two teams from the same league, it was 5 years ago, the very first Portsmouth Herald tournament, when Rotary and Lions from National were fighting it out at the National Little League field. So congratulations to both teams. There are no losers in tonight's game. You're the best in the city, and stand to be commended, and my congratulations.
See, folks, I knew these guys had a little something to say. Mike just made it a little bit longer. Rusty Wilson, Recreation Director for the City of Portsmouth.
Thanks very much. We let Mike speak next year. We'll ask about lights in case it gets dark. As most of you know, there's a tremendous amount of work putting in a tournament like this. The City of Portsmouth would like to certainly thank the Portsmouth Herald, the three league presidents, all the coaches and managers who put in a ton of time for the kids. Most of all, the parents who come down here practice after practice, and the drizzling games and the heart-burning games like tonight, and especially the kids, all the guys and girls that put in all those practices. This is what it's all about, kids. Congratulations to all of you, and may the best team win.
And now the general manager of the Portsmouth Herald. No, the editor. See, my bosses are here. I follow what they say. The editor of the Portsmouth Herald, David Solomon.
On behalf of the Portsmouth Herald and the Little League organization throughout Portsmouth, I just want to say welcome to this, the fifth annual championship game. Congratulations to Ricci Construction, Pic-N-Pay, all the teams that have played throughout the season, the parents that have backed them up, and the great coaching and support they've got from everyone who's a big fan and a big supporter of Little League, and we're big fans ourselves. So enjoy the game, and thanks for coming out.
Thank you, Mr. Fulton. And now, the manager, general manager of the Portsmouth Herald, Ted Stazak.
I had a big speech prepared. I threw it away. Good luck to both teams. And I presented the trophy to the winner at the end of the game.
And now if we can all stand for the national anthem.
Are you recording this?
Shut up and hats off, guys.
dirty.
And the first pitch coming in is strike one. And now from Ted, strike two. Hey, these guys know how to throw it a little bit different than I was opening day. Now that's play ball.
Second base, one ball, one strike to the Ricci Rockets.
A lot of crashes, taking a
O'Brien for the third out. Press Rafferty. And there's Paul, hit sideways out of play, nowhere. For there's D right two. Ball hit backwards, counts. Ball outside, two balls and two strikes to Mr. Rafferty. First batter in the second inning for Pic-N-Pay. And here's a little number eight up here. Come down into the third base. There's a ball that's going to go somewhere into left field. And Chrissy's on for the single. Runner at first base. Have Bickford watches ball one. And there's the ball hit. Bickford around first. He's taking for a second. And Dick, we have runners at second and third. One out. One out. Fires the ball outside. Dear right. Strike two. And he got a swinger. Fires the ball outside. And there's a little number. Hit to the shortstop. Picks off. Over to first.
Go!
Six to three for number three. Two. Sandy Pembeck. Nobody. between the Ricci manager and the Ricci rocket. The gamester. There's a strike. And runners advance. Right. Ball outside. One. And there's the ball in. And that one goes through.
Three.
And he got on looking for the third. There's a strike on the outside corner. shortstop over the first. Not in time. And Fluff is on with a single. Two, a runner at first base. Ball outside. There's one out. Ball two. And there's the ball. Hit to the shortstop. Back off over to second in time. Over to first out of time. Fourth to second for the first out. And he watches. A ball outside. Ball inside. There's ball three. There's the ball. It's in the air. It goes down. And we have runners. And first and second. There's a ball.
Yeah.
Ball inside. And there's the ball hit back to the pitcher. Picked up. Over to second for the four. There's the ball. Pic-N-Pay.